Hello everyone, welcome to this video lecture. Myself P Wadkar, working as assistant professor at WIT Solapur. In this video lecture we will study the PN junction diode. At the end of this video lecture, student will be able to examine working of PN junction diode. Student will be able to draw the VI characteristic of PN junction diode and state applications of PN junction diode. PN junction diode, it is the basic building block of semiconductor devices. It is made by joining P-type semiconductor with N-type semiconductor by a special fabrication process. Diode means two electrode, so the terminal which is connected to the P side, it is called as anode, and the terminal which is connected to the N side, it is called as cathode. This is the symbolic representation of PN junction diode. Here the arrowhead represent the direction of conventional current flowing through the device. This bar represent cathode, and this is the real appearance of PN junction diode. The PN junction diode, in that current conduction takes place due to the two types of semiconductor material, that is the P type and N type. The P-type semiconductor material is made up by adding the trivalent impurity into pure semiconductor. By addition of this trivalent impurity provides the free holes. So the current conduction takes place in P-type semiconductor, it is due to the holes. So holes are the majority charge carriers, and the electrons here are the minority charge carriers. The N-type semiconductor is made up of adding pentavalent impurity into pure semiconductor. So addition of this impurity provides large number of free electrons. So current conduction in N-type semiconductor is due to the electrons. So majority charge carriers here are electrons, and minority charge carriers are holes. When P-type semiconductor is joined to the N-type semiconductor, then there is a formation of PN junction diode. So the boundary or interface between this P-type and N-type semiconductor, it is called as a PN junction. The PN junction working modes. The PN junction works basically in three modes. First, it is equilibrium. It is also called as zero biasing mode. Here no external potential energy, that is no external supply is applied to the PN junction. Second, forward biasing mode. Here the positive terminal of external DC source is connected to the P region, and negative terminal is connected to the N region. And in reverse biasing mode, the negative terminal of external DC source is connected to the P region, and positive terminal is connected to the N region. Now first mode, that is the equilibrium mode. So here no any external supply is given to the device. So in this condition, at the initial condition, the majority charge carrier, that is the electron from N side, these electrons will diffuse into the P side. Okay? The atoms from N side which donates this electron, these atoms are get converted into the positively charged ion, and the atom from P side who accept these electrons, these atoms get converted into the negatively charged ion. So these positively charged and negatively charged ions accumulate near the junction. So there is one layer of these immobile ions towards N side positive and toward P side negative ions. So this layer is called as a depletion region. Due to this positively charged ions, there is a positive potential difference, and here the negative potential. So this, the potential difference is generated here. So this is nothing but building potential. It is also called as a potential barrier. So once this depletion region generates here, the majority charge carriers cannot cross the junction. Now next mode, that is the forward biasing. In this mode, the positive terminal of external DC source is connected to the P side of semiconductor. Negative terminal of external DC source is connected to the N type of semiconductor. So the battery connected in this way, the majority charge carriers, that is the electron from N side, will repelled towards the junction due to this negative terminal. And the majority charge carriers, that is the holes which are the positively charged, these holes will repel towards the junction due to this positive terminal. If due to this movement of electrons or repulsion of electrons and holes towards the junction, the width of depletion region decreases. As the external voltage increases, width of depletion decreases, and at one particular voltage, the depletion region completely collapses, and these majority charge carriers can cross the junction easily. Okay, due to this movement of majority carriers through the device, the current flows through the device, and that current is called as a forward current. So the VI characteristic, that is nothing but curve between the voltage across the junction along x-axis and current through the circuit along y-axis. It describes the DC behavior of the diode. Okay, so these are the forward VI characteristic. In this characteristic, on x-axis there is a forward voltage, on y-axis there is a forward current. In between region A to V, that is at the initial condition when the forward voltage is very small, the current flowing through the device is also very small. After point B, the current flowing through the device increases exponentially. So directly at point B, the depletion region completely get collapse and the current flowing through the circuit increases. So this point is called as a knee voltage, or it is also called as a cut-in voltage. Now next, reverse biasing of PN junction. In reverse biasing, negative terminal of external DC source is connected to the P side and positive terminal is connected to the N side. So due to this positive terminal, the negatively charged electrons from N side attracts towards the positive terminal, and positively charged holes from P type will attract towards the negative terminal. Okay? And due to that, the width of depletion region increases, that is depletion region expands here. So due to this, the barrier resistance is increases and majority charge carriers cannot flow through the junction. So there is no zero current due to the majority charge carriers. Now question, what happens to the minority charge carriers when the PN junction diode is reverse biased? Okay. Pause the video for a while and think. So in reverse biasing, at the P side there are minority charge carrier, that is the electrons, and at the N side minority charge carriers, that is the holes. Now we'll see how these electrons and holes, minority charge carriers, generated. So whenever the heat energy is applied to the atoms, the electrons from a valence band will break the covalent bond with parent atom, and these electrons becomes free. Okay, due to these electrons, the whatever the current flows through the device, that current is called as a reverse saturation current. Avalanche breakdown. Whenever the reverse voltage across the diode increases, minority charge carriers, that is the free electrons which are present in a P side, gains a higher energy, and they their movement takes place with the higher speed. Okay. These electrons will collide with the atoms and they knock off the more electrons. Okay. So these free electrons again collides with the another atom and they knock off more number of electrons. So in this way, large number of electrons generated here. Due to this, the current flows through the device. So we'll see how this avalanche breakdown takes place. So when due to the kinetic energy, these electrons get a higher energy. These electrons collide with the atoms and they knock off more electrons. These electrons again collide with the another atom, then knock off more electrons. So due to this continuous collision, large number of electrons are generated, and due to this, large amount of current flows through the device. Okay, so this condition is called as a avalanche breakdown mechanism. Are the reverse VI characteristic of PN junction diode. So here at the initial condition, very small reverse current flows. That current is called as a saturation current. This current is due to the minority charge carriers, which are thermally generated. Means they are depend upon this current is depend upon the temperature, not on a reverse voltage. So even increase in reverse voltage here, the current remains constant. Okay, so this is the reverse saturation current. After one particular voltage, the current increases rapidly. So that voltage is called as a breakdown voltage, where the breakdown of PN junction takes place. So PN junction diode can act as an automatic switch. So when diode is a reverse bias, switch is open, and when diode is a forward bias, the switch is closed. These are the some more application of PN junction diode. PN junction diode act as a rectifier to convert AC into DC, as a switch in computer circuit. It act as a detector in radios to detect audio signal. It is also used as a LED to emit different colors. These are the references. Thank you.